Hello everyone, in this video we will cover the section 1.3. In this section we will see vector equations, which is another form of linear equations in linear algebra. So for vector equations, firstly we should know the definition of vectors in two-dimensional, three-dimensional coordinate system. We saw the definition of vectors in calculus 2. Therefore, you can read yourselves this basic information here. So we will start with the definition of linear combination of vectors. Given vectors v1, v2, blah blah, vp in Rn, namely we have n components for each one, and given scalars c1, c2, blah blah, cp, the vector y defined by in this form, namely we have a multiple of the vectors here and we add them, so we get another vector which is stated by y here. So it is called a linear combination of v1, v2, blah blah, vp with weights c1, c2, blah blah, cp. They are scalars, they are numbers. And v1, v2, blah blah, vp are vectors. In Rn, you know, it has n components. And we can write v1 as a1, a2, blah blah, an. Okay, we have n components, and all of them will be real numbers. So when we have this addition here with weights c1, c2, cp, so we call it as a linear combination, and the weights in a linear combination can be any real numbers including zero. When we look at this example, so we have the vector a1, which is a vector in R cube, so we have another one, a2, and the components are 2, 5 and 6 for A2, and B has the components 7 for minus 3. So determine whether B can be generated as a linear combination of A1 and A2. That is, determine whether weights X1 and X2 exist such that B will be a linear combination of the vectors a1, a2, and the form of this vector will be in this form: x1 times a1 plus x2 times a2. Instead of c1 and c2, we write x1 and x2. And if we write the vector b like this one, so we say b is a linear combination of a1 and a2 with weights x1 and x2, or c1 and c2. The notation is not important for the scalars. You can use any letter for that stating the weights of the vectors. So if vector equation, this is a vector equation, you see on the left hand side of the equality we have addition of vectors, which is another vector, and the right side of the equality is a vector, therefore we have vector equality here. So if it has a solution, so find it. So how can we find? Use the definitions of scalar multiplication and vector addition to rewrite the vector equation. Writing the components of A1, A2, or using the matrix notation for them, so we obtain this one, okay, which is same as after applying the scalar multiplication. We obtain the components as x1 minus 2 times x1, you see easily. And for the second term we have the same application here: 2 times x2, 5 times x2 and 6 times x2, and the right side is the vector b. And applying the vector addition, vector equality, so we will obtain 7 is equal to x1 plus 2 times x2, and 4 is equal to minus 2 x1 plus 5 x2, and similarly the last one will be written as minus 3 is equal to minus 5 times x1 plus 6 times x2, you see. So the vectors on the left and right side of 2 are equal if and only if their corresponding entries are both equal. That is, x1 and x2 make the vector equation true if and only if x1 and x2 satisfy the following system. Just you should remember the vector equality. According to this one, we will equal the corresponding components easily. So we have a linear system, you see. We have three equations with two variables, which are x1 and x2. And you know how we can solve this equation. We will find the echelon form of the augmented matrix using the coefficients of the variables respectively. So we will obtain 1, minus 2, minus 5, 1, minus 2, minus 5, 2, 5, 6, 7, 4, minus 3. If you remember, to find the echelon form of the augmented matrix, this is the augmented matrix. First, we look at the first row to find the pivot position or the leading entry, if you remember. So 1 is the leading entry, this is the leftmost non-zero number here. And according to the properties of echelon form, if you remember, we should make 0, minus 2 and minus 5. Therefore, we will use the row operations to find 0 for minus 2. So the second row is replaced by, you know, you can find also easily R2 plus 2R1, R2 plus 2R1. And similarly, the third row will be replaced by R3 plus 5R1, 5R1. And then let's check R2 plus R2 plus 2R1. 2 minus 2, 0, 2 times 2, 4, plus 5, 9, 14 plus 4 is 18, okay, 2 times 7. And similar for the third row, 5 times 1, 5, minus 5 becomes 0, 5 times 2 is 10, 10 plus 6 is 16, and similarly, 14 minus 3, 47 times 5 is 35, minus 3 is 32. And then we should find the second pivot position. This is the first pivot. When we look at the second row, the leftmost non-zero constant is 9, and to find easily 0 for 16, so it will be better to get 1 for 9. Therefore, we will use the scaling operation. So R2 will be written as 1 over 9 R2. Okay. And you see we have 1 and 1 over 9, 1 over 9 times R2. Okay, we will divide the second row by 9. And we have 1, you see, and 2. And to get 0 for 16, we use again replacement, namely R3 is replaced by R3. Is replaced by R3 minus 16 R2. So we have minus 16 plus 16 becomes 0, minus 32 and plus 32 will be 0. Therefore, we have an echelon form of the augmented matrix of the linear system. And we don't have anything for the third row, which is the zero row. Therefore, we start with the second row. According to the second row, you see easily x2 is equal to 2. X2 is equal to 2 because the second column is corresponding to the variable x2, you know. And the first one is corresponding to the variable x1. They represent the numbers here in the first column, represents the coefficients of the variable x1 for the system. X2 is equal to 2, x3, x1 is equal to 3. Hence, B is a linear combination of A1 and A2 with weights 3 and 2. Okay, therefore, the vector B, you see as a vector equation, this linear combination, 3 times A1 plus 2 times A2. B is equal to 3 times A1 and A1 plus 2 times A2. 2 times A2. This is a linear combination of the vectors A1 and A2. So now observe that the original vectors A1, A2 and B are the columns of the augmented matrix that we row reduced. Okay, if you look at carefully the augmented matrix, so the first column is A1 and the second column is A2 and the last one is corresponding to B for the vector equation. Okay, namely this matrix actually is equivalent to the vector equation x1 times a1 plus x2 times a2 is equal to b. This is another form of the linear system. Okay, we can state a linear system in matrix notation and vector notation. You see, we have two options to state a linear system compactly. So write this matrix in a way that identifies its columns. Okay, namely, instead of writing this one, so directly we write the vectors, you see, A1, A2 and B. So a vector equation x1 times a1, a1, a2, blah blah, an are vectors and b is the vector which is on the right hand side of the vector equation has the same solution set as the linear system whose augmented matrix is a1, a2, blah blah, an, b. In particular, B can be generated by a linear combination of A1, A2, blah blah, An, if and only if there exists a solution to the linear system corresponding to the matrix 5. As we see in the example, this matrix is corresponding to the linear combination of the vectors, and B is equal to x1, A1 plus X2, A2. So if you want to find whether B is a linear combination of the vectors A1 and A2, so it is enough to find the solution of the linear system corresponding to the matrix, which will be the augmented matrix of the system by using the vectors A1, A2 and B. This matrix easily can be found just by writing the components of the vectors respectively. The first column is corresponding to A1 and the second column will be A2 and the last column will be B. And similarly, if we state this generally, in general form, so the vector equation will be x1, a1, x2, a2, blah blah, xn, an, and the matrix obtained here will be like this one. Okay, for the first column we write the components of a1, for the second column we write the components of a2, and in such a way that we will find a matrix. Okay, And this matrix will be the augmented matrix of the system, linear system. And in order to find whether B is a linear combination of the vectors or B can be generated by a linear combination of the vectors A1, A2, blah, blah, AN. So we will find the solution of the system such that the augmented matrix will be this one. Okay? So from this, we will see very important definition. If V1, V2, blah, blah, Vp, we have P vectors, are in Rn, then the set of all linear combinations of V1, V2, blah, blah, Vp is denoted by span V1, blah, blah, Vp, and is called the subset of Rn spanned by or generated by the vectors given here. Namely, span V1, blah, blah, Vp is the collection of all vectors that can be written in the form which will be a linear combination of the given vectors with scalars C1, C2, blah, blah, Cp. Okay? So in set notation, the set will be written as, namely, the set of all linear combinations of the given vectors, which is denoted by span V1, V2, blah, blah, Vp, is equal to, it is the collection of all vectors, let's say y, okay, such that y is a linear combination of the vectors c1, v1, blah, blah, cp, vp, and c1, c2, cp are real numbers. Okay, this is a set of vectors, and we have the only condition for vectors in this set. So the vector should be a linear combination of the given vectors, which are v1, v2, blah, blah, vp. And we have infinitely many vectors in this set, because when we change the values of the weights, values of the scalars, c1, c2, blah, blah, cp, so we obtain a lot of vectors from here. Therefore, this set has infinitely many vectors generally, okay, by changing the values of the scalars. So this special set is called the subset of Rn spanned by or generated by the vectors v1, v2, blah, blah, vp. Okay, just by changing the values of scalars, we obtain different vectors. So when we see a geometric description of spanning set, so let V be a non-zero vector in R³, then span V is the set of all scalar multiples of V, which is the set of points on the line in R³ through V and the origin, and we can see this fact in this figure. If you remember the parametric equation of a line in R³, when we know a point on the line, and if you know it's also direction vector, let's say vector V, okay, on the line. So the parametric equation, if you remember, let's say this is the line L, and its parametric equation will be P0 plus T times V. P0 plus T times V. When we change the value of T here, which is the parameter, So we obtain all the points on the line, okay? And if we take the point P0 as the origin, so the line becomes just T times V, T times V. And by using the definition of the subset of Rn spanned by the only vector V, we have just one vector here. So the general definition is equal to the vector Y, which is equal to C times V, such that C is a real number. C is a real number. Therefore, when we compare them, so we see the same context here actually. Therefore, we will get a line, namely the subset of R cube spanned by the only vector V will be corresponding to a line whose initial or whose line through the origin zero. Okay, and you can see this is passing through the origin, and the direction vector will be the vector V, and from here we find also its direction vector. So this will be corresponding to a line passing through the origin, and its direction vector is V. Okay, so we understood that in three dimensional space span V, namely when we have the only single vector, so it is corresponding to a line. It is corresponding to a line, as you can see. This is the geometric interpretation. Another one: if U and V are non-zero vectors in R cube, with V not a multiple of U, then the spanning set of the vectors U and V is the plane in R cube that contains U, V, and the zero vector, namely the origin. In particular, the subset of R cube spanned by the vectors U and V contains the line in R cube passing through the vector U and the zero vector, and the line through the vector V and the zero vector. You can see this is the vector U and this one is the vector V, okay, in R cube. And when we apply the definition, namely the subset of R cube spanned by the vectors U and V is equal to C1, so is equal to, if you remember, this is the collection of all vectors Y, such that Y is equal to C1 times U plus C2 times V. For example, if we take 1 for C1 and C2, so we will have an element of this set. So just we write U plus V. If we take, for example, 3 for C1 and 2 for C2, another element will be in the form 3 times U plus 2 times V, and so on. By giving values for the scalar C1 and C2, we obtain elements of this set, which is a subset of R cube spanned by the vectors U and V. And we will look at the elements here. U plus V is corresponding to this vector actually, okay? And this vector is corresponding to a point in R cube, which is the terminal point, because the initial point is always the origin. And 3 times U plus 2 times V, 3 times U plus 2 times V will be corresponding to this one, this vector, okay? And when look at the initial point, so we see these points are lying on the same plane, you see. And so on, by finding another vectors in this set, So we will obtain the points, which are the terminal points, on the same plane. Okay. Therefore, this is corresponding to, this set is corresponding to a plane passing through the origin. Okay. Passing through the origin, a plane passing through the origin. Passing through the origin. Okay, so let's see some examples about that. For example, let A1 is a vector in R cube whose components are 1, minus 2, 3, 1, minus 2, 3, and A2 has the components 5, minus 13, minus 3. And B has the components minus 3, 8, 1. So is B in the plane? Is B in the plane, which is actually the set spanned by the vectors A1 and A2, and you see A1 is not a multiple of A2, therefore this set is a plane in R cube. So you know, you can find easily. So we understood that in order to say that B is a vector in the plane span A1, A2, so B should be written as a linear combination of the vectors A1 and A2, namely C1, A1 plus C2, A2. And if you remember directly, this vector equation can be written in matrix notation. So we write A1, A2, and B. Okay, this is the eight matrix of the system, actually, which is rewritten as 1, minus 2, 3, A1, 5, minus 13, minus 3, and B, minus 3, 8, 1. After necessary row operations, you can do yourselves. So we will obtain the echelon form of this matrix will be 1, 0, 0. Okay, this is your homework. 5, minus 3, 0. And minus 3, 2, minus 2. Okay. This is the first pivot position, the second pivot position, and for the last column we don't look for the pivot positions, okay, because the last column is corresponding to the right hand side of the linear system, you know. So when we look at the third row, okay, when we look at the third row, the coefficients are zero, namely the left hand side of the equation is zero, but the right hand side is minus two, which is an impossible situation. Therefore, there is no solution. Okay, there is no solution, which means that B is not a vector in the plane spanned by the given vectors a1 and a2. This vector does not lie in the plane, on the plane, okay, spanned by the vectors a1 and a2, because we cannot find the weights, the scalars c1 and c2 according to the result. After finding the echelon form, you see, according to the last row, so we have impossible case here. Therefore, we say that B is not a vector in the plane. Another example. So for what value or values? Values of H will the vector Y be in the set spanned by the vectors V1, V2 and V3 if V1 has the components 1, minus 1, minus 2, and V2 has the components 5, minus 4, minus 7, and V3 has the components minus 3, 1, 0. Okay, and the vector Y has the components minus 4, 3, h. So for what value of h or values of h can we write the vector y as a linear combination of the vectors v1, v2 and v3? Okay, this is the definition of the set spanned by the vectors v1, v2 and v3. So let's solve. So we should write the vector y to say that y is in the set spanned by the vectors v1, v2, v3 as a linear combination, c1 times v1 plus c2 times v2 plus c3 times v3. And the matrix notation for this linear system will be written as C1, C2, C3, and the last one is the vector Y, you know, and this is corresponding to 1, minus 1, minus 2, which is corresponding to the scalar C1, 5, minus 4, minus 7, and minus 3, 1, 0. And the last column, you know, is the vector y, namely the right side of the equality, actually, minus 4, 3, and h. Okay, so for this, let's find the echelon form of this augmented matrix. The pivot position for the first row is 1, you see, and so we should get 0 for minus 1 and minus 2. Therefore, R2 is replaced by R2 plus R1, and the third one will be replaced by R3 plus 2R1. So the matrix becomes 1 0 0 5 r2 plus r1, so we have 1 and minus 3 minus 2 minus 4 and minus 1, yes. And the third row will be 0, the second one 10 minus 7 is 3, and minus 6 plus 0 is minus 6. And 2 times minus 8, so we have h minus 8 for the last one. And the second pivot position, when we look at the second row, is the leftmost non-zero constant, which is again 1 here. So to get 0 for my for the number 3, so we write r3, as namely we replaced r3 with r3 plus or r3 plus, so we should obtain 3 here, therefore we write minus actually minus 3 r2, therefore we have 1 0 0 5 1 0 minus 3 minus 2, so minus 3 plus 6, minus 6 becomes 0, and minus 4 minus 1, minus 3 plus 3, so we have h minus 5, okay. And according to the last row, you see the left hand side of the system is 0 because all entries are 0 except the last one, because the last one is corresponding to the right hand side of the equation, and the right hand side will be equal to h minus 5. So to get a solution for the system, so we should obtain this equality. So to get the equality, h should be equal to 5. H should be equal to 5. So we can say y is in the set spanned by the vectors v1, v2 and v3 if h is equal to 5. If you write another number except 5, so we don't get the equality written here, which means that there is no solution for the system, which means that we cannot find the scalars C1, C2 and C3 for this system. So y is not in the set spanned by the given vectors, therefore h has to be equal to 5. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much. See you later.